All right, ready?
So, just to review, if I get it, it'll turn green, and then if I miss a human subject, a human target, then it grunts.
Yep.
What?
You have to remember to press the trigger.
So much grunt.
We are exploring the future of the human body and what humans will be capable of in 2050. In this episode, memory boosting. How will super memory work?
What will it mean when we can learn faster and remember better simply by zapping our brains a little bit? And what if someone can overwrite your memory and manipulate what's real? Let's find out in this episode of Future You with me, Elise Hugh.
It is nighttime, and we are in the Department of Psychology at the University of New Mexico, and I'm going to spend the night here in this self-enclosed space for two nights. One night without stimulation to my brain, and then the second night with electrodes connected to my brain. And the reason why is because we're going to see if my memory can be improved while I'm sleeping by zapping it.
Vince Clark heads the Psychology Neuroscience Center at the University of New Mexico. Over the past few years, he and his team have tested all sorts of ways to enhance our brain's ability to learn and remember. In a multi-year study funded by the U.S. military's research arm, DARPA, they made this stunning discovery. If your brain gets zapped during a certain stage of sleep, it boosts your memory of the day before. How well does this work? The researchers are letting me give it a try.
Nice to meet you, Aaron.
Nice to meet you, too.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Since this was originally designed for the military, the mental task is a VR game involving shooting, photos of human targets that appear in this desert scene.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
So I'm looking for humans to move
You're
to take a photo of.
Yep.
Wait, what? Oh my gosh,
remember to move your head.
Oh, he grunted.
At first, this is a struggle, but eventually, I get the hang of it. Training complete. Time to go to bed.
Okay, I've brushed my teeth. The only way that I can even access the outside world is through this walkie-talkie. But otherwise, I'm about to go to bed, so good night for night one. Good night for control night. I get tested on my memory tomorrow. Bye.
When you close your eyes at night and drift off to sleep, your brain begins its work on memory consolidation through four stages of sleep. Slow-wave sleep, or deep sleep, helps your brain encode long-term memories. While you're sleeping, your brain reviews what happened during the day and it stores information that you received. The super slow oscillations in your brain waves coordinate all this. Researchers found if they hook up your brain, record the slow waves, use some advanced math to extract that data, then program a system to stimulate your brain during slow wave sleep, the process of storing your memories is noticeably better. Research subjects who got stimulated at night have better recall of what they learned the night before.
It's about 7 o'clock. They just woke me up with a walkie-talkie.
So after the first night, I'm tested on this task to get a base of what my memory is like. This will get compared to my stimulated brain tomorrow.
This is gonna be really quiet without the grunts.
To pass the time before night two, we took in a little Albuquerque. The sunsets make for memories worth boosting. Then, back in my PJs. This time, the researchers attach electrodes to my head so they can read my brain signals while I sleep.
Here's my tail.
One more time on the VR game before an overnight memory stimulation. The researchers have to keep the brain bonnet nice and fitted for the night so it can correctly read when I'm in deep sleep. Sleeping in a lab with a bunch of wires attached to my head is rough, but once I fell into that slow wave sleep, they stimulated my brain cells with something called TACS, transcranial alternating current stimulation. The technique figures out my brain's frequency for memory encoding and then feeds that same current back into my brain to enhance my memories.
Are you in bed?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm coming in just to...
Good morning.
Bye, Bonnet. Bye. This is the key VR test. After brain stimulation, will my performance improve? Will my brain have learned something, either explicitly or subconsciously, to make me better at recognizing targets?
Yeah, so let me orient you to the graphs first.
Okay.
So the figure on the left is your performance from your first day.
Before we find out, let's put our memory expert and neuroscientist, Vince Clark, through our scenarios for how this plays out in the year 2050.
In the year 2050.
What is going to be superhuman about us if we can accelerate our learning and our memories this way?
There will be technologies that will allow you to learn things better, store them better, recall them better later, things like that. They already exist today. It's just a matter of making it even more effective and easier to use and inexpensive. Once you encode memory, it's really hard to forget. And that's probably the reason why we're able to do it, because your brain is actually designed not to encode a memory until you're really sure it's true. And what we're doing is by boosting that process a little bit, we kind of reduce the threshold that you need in order to be able to encode the memory.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about that. What are supervillain uses of this? So, you know, Lex Luthor gets this.
Yeah.
How is he going to use this?
If he can manipulate how people dream at night or how people come up with their stories and consolidate their memories.
Will we have memory overwriting capabilities in the future?
People are working on that too. It's possible that it could be misused and you could force someone to have a memory that wasn't really true somehow. Although it would take a lot more work than what we're doing now is just enhancing a natural process. We're not really manipulating details about what you learn and all. But as we get better, that might be possible.
So memory manipulation, it sounds super scary if our heads can be messed with externally while we're sleeping. What do you imagine? So if this exists, how do you imagine society will respond? Have you thought this through?
So I see different patterns of responses. My feeling is we're already doing it. Commercials are designed to change our feelings and our perspective about products or about things that we could spend money on. And they're very good at that. A good commercial can change our culture. So we've been dealing with this for a long time.
Well, what if a government wants to do it to promote nationalistic ideas or something though, right?
Right. Using medication too. I mean, experiments with different kinds of medication. How do you make people placid? Things like that. Governments have looked at this for a long time.
What do you expect, Dr. Clark, to be super likely given this technology?
I think we'll get better at being able to enhance people's ability to learn. Also things like pay attention, doing sports, and medical treatments like reducing pain. We already have ways using electricity and magnetism to do that.
All right, a very hopeful take. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
How did I do? This surprises me, but somehow my performance improved. I couldn't explain how I came to hit the targets faster, but I did. I'm not a true scientific subject, though. I'm just trying something that years of double-blind scientific research with hundreds of subjects bore out.
What does this prove?
That we can use transcranial stimulation during the night to improve other kinds of memory, not just like kind of veridical, declarative sorts of memory.
What the research found is stimulation improves memory generalization. My brain somehow did recognize a pattern that the threats appeared in and learned it with the help of tiny zaps to my head. Even if I couldn't explain the pattern out loud, the learning happened. Pretty cool, right?
Okay. Checking out. Checking out of the sleep lab. Oh, this way. Bye. Bye.
So the possibilities for this, for learning new skills or just remembering better, are pretty huge. And get this, researchers are already finding evidence that they don't have to boost your memory while you're asleep. This is already working in some studies for those who are awake. How about that for the future you? We invite you to watch this whole series. You can watch it on NPR's channel on YouTube or at npr.org/futureyou. Okay, bye.